Friday night showdown. When the devil's in the field, you'll hear a roar through the whole town. The field's all ready, so somebody get the lights. It's Lincoln County football here on Football Friday night. So come on, all you fans of the mighty red and white, and see the Red Devils get another win tonight.
Captains are heading out. Now, where's Lieutenant Dan? There he is.
There he is.
All right, we're going to take it down to Dan Rosser with the sideline mic for the coin toss.
Okay, look, I know before, y'all got any questions? I got a flag on the ground, a hollow wire. Explain my options, y'all. Let me know what you want, okay? Okay, Ford, are you going to call my coin?
Yes, sir.
All right, that head is a head. And all that writing is a tail, okay?
Yes, sir.
If I drop it, I'm going to flip it again.
Yes,
what do you want to call it?
Tails.
You want to call tails. And ended up ahead. Don't get y'all's choice. You want the ball? Okay. You get your choice of goals. You want to defend the clock and kick it that way, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Turn your back on this side. You got it.
All right. Lincoln County won the toss, and we're going to have the we're going to be going toward the gym.
All right. Thank you, Dan. Like I said, right. We won the coin toss. We elected to receive
the football. Yeah,
I think they must be thinking, let's get the ball, let's get some points on the board in a hurry, and we're not going to worry about coming out and getting it first, second half. We'll let them have it. Hopefully, the game will be put away. Hopefully,
that would be nice. That would be nice. So, we're just a few minutes away from kickoff, and like we told you, it's homecoming. And so, halftime, we'll be having, what do they do, homecoming queen and, like, princess or something, don't they? They do, too.
Runner-up princess
something.
And
they
queen.
Call it a princess or something, yeah.
And I think I saw in the paper where tonight at the dance after the game, they'll be crowning the homecoming king and prince.
Oh.
So.
That's something different.
Now, the one thing that we're going to be doing, having to do a little different this year than I've had to do for the past 24 years, is we're on the visitor side. And before, I've always been on the home side. And I could halfway tell you what was going on and what everybody was wearing. But this year, it will
be a little different.
Well, the tail of the homecoming queen.
the tail.
Tails from the dark side here.
You'll be able to kind of see. They always come, you know, down here.
They come around here,
across,
but
so.
My memory's about as far as the 50-yard line to the 45. By the time they start here and get across the field.
It's going to be all gone.
I can tell you what the backside looked like.
All right. Well, here comes Aquinas taking the field now there. I'm guessing what they dressed 25, maybe 30 players at the most, Doug, perhaps.
Well, they got numbers go up to the 70s. Oh, they don't start at one and go up to the.
No, they do not.
Oh,
they,
boy, I've been thinking that a lot. They look like probably, but well, let's get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
36. Oh, that, okay.
I don't know. That just sounded good.
Get around number one. Well, of course, they're in their tribal jerseys, gray pants. No, let's go. Gold pants, white shirts trimmed in green, numbers in green, and with their traditional gold helmets. We're in red helmets, red jerseys, and gray or silver breeches.
Now, they don't have any things on the helmets. It seems like in the past they've had
something
on the side of
their
helmets.
I don't know if they had they may have had just an A on it.
A or it seems like they've had a little leprechaun type guy on it.
You know,
they kind of got the Green Bay. I mean, not.
The
Notre Dame.
So, Aquinas is going to kick here in just a moment, and we'll get this thing on the way.
And Lincoln County, they're in the gray pants, red jerseys with the white under the sleeve, a little sleeveret thing up under there, and the red helmets, of course. We will be receiving with our backs to the flagpole. Aquinas will be kicking with their backs to the clock. Back deep for Lincoln County. The deep man is 24, Ursel Daniel. Two up men, and number three, Jathan Mickens and
Jones.
Craig 11. Jones. Yeah. So let's see. We're waiting on that official to. And this game is underway. Good high end over end kick. Feel it at the 10 by number three. He's got a lane on the far right side. One man left between him and the end. He cuts back in, that one man nails him right at the 48. He almost gets it back to midfield.
Yeah, that was Mickens on the return, and he caught it down in this in this corner toward the road over here near the visitor stands. He cut it up the middle, and the guys created him a great wall or wedge, and he returned it about 40-something yards out to, we'll call it, about the nose of the ball, trying to touch the 50.
Almost.
Yeah, and we'll take over first and 10.
Nose of the ball is sniffing at the 50-yard line. All right, Sherman back up under the center. Got one set back. Are we going with the jab formation? Got the man in motion, number one, and then we handed that number one, and he was in motion, takes away around the right side and gets way downfield across the 30, right near the 25.
Yeah, Kilpatrick going to take one carry and go 25 yards. We talked to you a little bit last week. We really liked his vision that he showed us up there in Commerce, and so he's going to get – he's one of our seniors, going to get plenty of carries and playing time now with AG out. First and 10, Lincoln County on the Aquinas 25.
Got Tyler Banks wide out on the left side. Same formation in the backfield. Got the one set back. Got the man in motion right to left to number 15. They hand it to him, and he's going to cut between tackle and end spot. Gets it across the 20, down to just shy of the
16,
15.
Yeah, that was
about
Devontae.
9.5 yards, depending on where they spot him.
Yeah, they actually dug. They kind of stacked him up right there on about the 20, and the lineman, along with Devontae, just kept pushing the pile and pushed it for another 3 or 4 yards. We're going to have it second and one on their 16-yard line. No score early in the first quarter.
Two plays, two big gains, and we're in the red zone. McGahee, the setback. Wings on either side, wide out on the right side. Man in motion, left or right. It's time to hand to McGahee, going straight up the middle, and he's going to get down for a touchdown.
So, three plays, we go 50 yards. Looks like we're playing, with a little bit of a purpose tonight. It's homecoming here in Lincoln County. And
what was that, a 16-yard run?
Yeah.
16-yard McGahee run.
He got so excited, we're waiting on him for just a second to come out to kick the PAT.
And that's Walker Smith getting set to kick that extra point. Snaps there, kick is up. Kick is
automatic.
Good, right through the middle. Not high, not long, but just
right.
It's there. What
there.
Else can you say?
Once again, he's done an excellent job stepping up this year. We went to the soccer team and got him, and has done a superb job. So, with 10:39 to go in the first quarter, Lincoln County has jumped out on top, 7-0. And I would venture to say that this is our quickest lead of the year.
Yeah, three plays. Kickoff, three plays, touchdown.
Yeah, so we're going to take a 7-0 lead, like we said, and Smith's fixing to tee it up and give Aquinas the ball. It just seems like they just got a little bit of energy about them tonight, so, and which is good. We're fixing to hit that stretch now that it really matters.
And really, all three of the backs got the ball.
Yeah, they sure
started
did.
Started off
everybody
with
touched.
The wing on the left. He goes in motion, gets it in full stride. The wing on the right gets it, comes back around the other way, then head to the setback going up the middle. Kind of a line drive, tight punt kick. Fielded at about the 12 by Aquinas. He's out to the 20, 25, 30. And finally brought down to about the 34, and that's where Aquinas will start their first possession of this homecoming 2009 game with Lincoln County.
Yeah, Walker really thumped it pretty good, but like you said, it was kind of a line drive, not a very good coverage kick. But so now if we can get him to get it up in the air a little bit with that distance, that'll really help him. You can kind of tell as the season's going on that Smith's leg is definitely getting stronger. Aquinas' ball, first and 10 on their own 34.
Aquinas coming out, looked like they're in the I formation, wide outs to either side. Lincoln County under 53 defense. And they're going to hand off to the setback, going straight up the middle. Hits a whole about 9 Lincoln County players. Only see 2 that's not standing around in that pile.
And they would kind of go in with their receivers down the field. So it's good to see Mr. Kreit back out there tonight. Allen's back after a week off, week's vacation. So good to have him back, causing some chaos. Going to cause some chaos up the middle. Has done an excellent job for us, and he's just a sophomore. So, here we go again with youth.
All right, second 9 for Aquinas. The ball on the 35. I formation. Quarterback dropping, rolling to his left side, looking to pass. Gets the pass off. It's a high one, and deflected down by number 24, Daniel.
Yeah, excellent play that time by Ursell, just doing what he's taught to do. He kind of read the eyes of the quarterback right there. They had that big number 88 kind of breaking open, and Ursell comes back and makes an excellent defensive play, going to bring up third down and nine for Aquinas. They're still stuck on their own 35. 9:43 to go in the quarter. We're up 7-0.
And he threw that kind of into double coverage, but we also, Ursell did the right thing. He was the up man. He could afford to come up and slap because he had extra help behind him. Fakes some handoffs. Quarterback drives back, throws out to his right, in and out of the hands of a intended receiver at the 45. So to bring up fourth down for Aquinas at their own 35, be fourth and nine.
The quarterback that time threw a very catchable pass out to an open receiver who would have had first down distance. I said very catchable. It was a little high, but it was catchable. Like my daddy used to say, hit him in the wrong place, right in the hands. So Aquinas is going to punt. We're 9:37 in the first quarter, and your Red Devils are up a touchdown.
Punter standing back on his own 23. Our receiver got two men back around the 30. It's going to be a high punt. He's going to get fielded, and he's going to get brought down immediately at about the 27. Kind of a dangerous catch, man. The defender was right there in his face when he got it.
Yeah, that was Devontae. Who, of course, at least he did catch it, but did not move an inch as an Irish was right on top of him. And we're going to take over, looks like, on our 28-yard line, first down and 10, maybe 27-yard line, first down. Lincoln County, 9:25 to go in the quarter, 7-0 Lincoln County.
Now, did y'all let folks know about A.G., you know, that he had the surgery, titanium rod, all those kinds of things?
No.
Okay, A.G. has titanium rod in his leg, had the surgery, says he's feeling good. But, of course, we won't see him anymore this season, unfortunately.
All right. Thank you, Dan. Sherman up under center, dropping back, three-step drop back, throws it out in the right flats, so number 15's got a reception, picks up about 7 yards, looks like it's going to be.
We'll move it out, looks like, Doug, to the 35-yard line. So we throw a little quick hitter out there to Devontae.
Devontae right on the reception.
So we're going to have it second and we'll call it a short three for Lincoln County. Now on 35, 9 minutes to go, and we're up 7.
Turner coming out wide on the left side. We're running that double wing formation with the setback. Sherman up under the center. Aquinas got nine people up in the two-yard box there. Man motion left to right, hand to the number one again. He's got the corner turn, breaking tackles. Looks like it was there a fumble over there or something?
No, they just where he was toting the ball. Kilpatrick goes for about 15 yards that time. It just was not a beautiful way to tote it. You saw what I saw. It looked like it was.
Yeah, it looked like
but
so.
That was actually him swinging
him
it, I believe. Yeah. So Desmond hits a quick 15, and we'll take over first and 10. The ball is sitting right on top of the 50, and we're up 7 points.
Dan, from where you at, Danny, can you tell, is he getting that corner that quick, or is there the end's just not coming in and forcing stuff back in? Next time they go in motion, check on that and see, because it's hard to believe he's getting around that corner like that. Motion man from right to left this time, but they're going to hand him McGahee, trying to go up the middle, breaks a tackle at the 50 and manages to pick up about 4 more yards and gets it down to the 46.
Actually, Doug, I think they slipped Morris in on us on that.
Was that Morris?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
That was Morris. Doug, can you run that back by me? I was talking to one of the coaches when you
Well, the way Kilpatrick is hitting that corner, he's in motion, but nobody's out there pinching it down to make him come back in. Is he that quick getting there, or is our offensive ends blocking their end?
Yeah, we're holding that corner really well. We're blocking real well on that little move.
Because it seems like there's no contain out there at all forcing our guys when they're going in motion and taking handoff going through the corners.
Well, you know what's happened? The wing that's sitting on that side is the one that's actually making the block
that
hole.
Okay,
yep.
Got the extra blocker there. And it's a little pass play to 15 right, and another reception. Picks up about 2 yards out of it. It's going to bring up third, probably about third and five for Lincoln County.
We ran that same play. We picked up about 7 a while ago, and it was complete. But just like you said, Doug, picked up just a couple of yards that time. Third down and 5 for Lincoln County. Now on the Aquinas 45. We're 7 minutes in the quarter, and we're up a touchdown.
the huddle, putting two wide receivers out on the left side, one on the right, shotgun formation, set back with Sherman. Sherman dropping back, looking, steps up and throws. He's got his receiver, number 11, breaks a tackle at the 40, the 30, and finally brought down inside the 25 at about the 23. And that is Craig Jones, sophomore, on the reception.
22 yards from Sherman to Jones, and we're going to have a first down on their 23-yard line. He threw it. That was a good pass right there. Franklin was under a little bit of distress, so to speak. He threw a strike to Jones, and we pick up a big first down, and we'll have it there on their 23. 6 minutes and 25 seconds to go. We're up 7-0.
All right, Sherman back up under the center this time. He's got McGahee, the setback, standing back about 5 yards. Got the wing, wingman in motion, turn, hand to him again. This time he cuts it inside. Pursuit was out there, so he cuts it in, gets it inside the 20, about the 18. And that's what you're talking about. He's got good eyes and quick feet. He saw that Contain was swinging out deep, so he just cut in behind it.
Exactly. And that's, man, that is vision all the way. Like you said, that their defensive end strung it out. So what he done, he cut it up, 5 yards. You know,
it's almost like a quarterback reading the option. You know, he's kind of reading where the hole is on that line as he comes down.
So we're going to be second down. We'll call it 6 on their 14. We're up 7-0. 19.
Got Banks wide on the left. Got the wing. Hank goes in motion again. This time it's going to be the toss sweep to McGahee going around the right side. He gets hit, spins around, stays on his feet, gets inside the 15. Finally down at about the 12, but it'll be a first down, I believe.
It's going to be close, ain't it?
It is a first down. You can go ahead and call it.
All right.
Straight from Lieutenant Dan, it's a first down.
I guarantee you, first and 10. The ball now sitting on, we'll call it their 13, maybe 12 and a half, something like that. The clock running now, 5 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the quarter, and we've already scored once. We're up 7-0.
We're in the shotgun. Got a setback with Sherman. That's McGahee back there. He's got Kilpatrick wide on the left side. Two receivers on the right, and it's going to be a quarterback keeper from the shotgun, and he gets it, punches it down to about the 10, picks up about 2.5 yards.
We'll give him 2 on that, just kind of a little quarterback, not necessarily draw right when he got it. He kind of went ahead and sprinted up the middle and picked up a couple yards. Second down and 8, we're on the Aquinas 10-yard line trying to score again. We've already scored once.
Let's see, the clock's down, 4:33. 7-0, Lincoln County. This is our second possession of the game. First time we got it, we took the kickoff, and 3 plays later we scored. Now we're going with 3 receivers on the right side. Shotgun formation. One of the receivers on the right side goes in motion, comes up this side, and it's going to be a Sherman keeper again. This time he doesn't get back to the line.
Fumble the football.
He fell back on it. No. Actually, Billy McWhorter's got it coming up out of the pile there.
Billy Mack.
Yeah, so we laid it on the ground for a second, but McWhorter recovers the Sherman fumble, and that's, we maybe lose a yard on that. It's going to bring up 3rd down, and looks like 9 now. 3:50 to go in the quarter. We're on top 7-0. 8 yards to go. Gilly said it's still just 8, so.
8 yards to go.
Yeah, I take Gilly's word for it. Have you got a list of our sponsors out so we can?
Yeah.
Look at my man. Look at that. You got it together, Big D.
Hey, some things are just second nature. Shotgun formation again. Sherman rolling left, throws across the middle.
Ah.
And who was that? Was it
Scott? I think it was intended for Rusty, which would have been a great catch. Actually, kind of
threw it into triple coverage.
Yeah, but Rusty had his hand on it, and it just couldn't quite. 2 or 3 guys kind of banging
when three
him around.
People are hitting you, and you're trying to catch that ball. Yeah. It's kind of hard to do.
So Walker going to come in and.
Yeah, that'd be kind of like trying to catch a football while you're driving a bumper car.
Yeah. Is this our first field goal attempt?
Second. I think McCormick blocked one. So this will be about a 28-yarder. I'd like to see him drill this thing.
Placing it down about the 18, 10 inside the end zone. Snaps there, kicks up.
Right.
And it is.
Do it, buddy.
Good. Field goal, 3:18 to go in the first quarter still. Lincoln County gets another 3 points.
And he dug. He may have had another 10 maybe on that. So we're looking at a kicker now. It's like he's going to be, you know, good from 35 in maybe, or, you know, So congratulations to Mr. Smith on his first career field goal as a Red Devil. And he gives us a 10-point lead in this. It's good to kind of go ahead and jump out on top pretty early and pretty quick and keep it this way.
Yes.
It looks like Aquinas is going to be throwing the football a good bit tonight. They threw it two out of the three plays that they had it the first time, but you just don't never know.
I think they had
a receiver, though, that's for the last two games combined has caught for over 300 yards.
Oh, is that right?
In the paper, yeah.
All right, Smith is kicking off. Gets a little bit of height to it this time. It's fielded at about the 12. And the receiver's going to come from his left side, coming to our right side, and he's going to go from the 12 and bring it all the way out to about the 27. And that's where Aquinas will start this possession.
And that's a good job kick coverage. Yeah, Ursel, what he done is I just saw him fighting this guy all the way down and actually made the return guy turn it up when we had a guy waiting on him there. So, you know, it ain't all about trying to outrun your blocker. Just he fought him all the way down and did his job. Good job tonight by ourselves so far.
And let's see this is Aquinas' second possession?
Second, yeah.
Then the eye wide outs to either side. Lincoln County into 53. And quarterback steps back, acts like he's going to pass, and tucks it and hands it to his fullback. Coming off the right side, gets it across the 30 and down at about the 33. Picks up about 6 yards.
Yeah, we had a little bit of penetration, and I actually thought we were going to get him maybe for at least on the line, but he kind of made a pretty good little move up in there between the guard and tackle and picks up, like you said, 6 yards. It's going to be second down and 4 for Aquinas. They trail us now 10-0.
Aquinas breaking the huddle, put a wide to the right. No, actually, he got confused. He's going to the left. They got three receivers on the left side. Shotgun formation, set back with the quarterback in a wing. And they go ahead to the setback. He comes, counted up the middle, picks up. I thought he was down. He's still on his feet. And he's got the first down. I thought he was down about at the line of scrimmage. What happened?
I don't know. He's going to pick up about 13 yards, though. Wow. Some nifty little running. And I think we just thought maybe we had him and just kind of let him go. And he sprints out to their 45. It's going to be first and 10 Aquinas. On their own 45-yard line, Lincoln County is on top 10-0.
We thought the fullback or the running back had the ball. The quarterback had the ball. Quarterback was the one who ran out there with that.
I'm sorry.
You're right.
Fullback handed the ball.
Yeah, but the number 5 ended up with that ball. So I don't remember. I couldn't see if he handed it to him or what. But, yeah, 44 was the one we were tackling. Undoubtedly, he had the ball for a second. He must have given it to 5 because 5 is the one that broke away.
Something transpired there. Shotgun formation, quarterback for Aquinas, rolling, getting pressure, gets it off. Intercepted by 24. Gets it on our side, tries to go the other way, and finally dragging down. He intercepted it about the 39 and trying to loop around, got thrown back to the 30, we'll call it 35.
Ursel intercepts. He made a great play, we told you, just a little while ago. Now, I don't necessarily agree with this spot. They grabbed him and slung him. I mean, regardless, but we got the interception, but I ain't crazy about that spot. We'll take over on our own 35 on a number 24 Sale Daniel interception. We have it first and 10 on our own 35, 1:30 to go in the quarter. We're on top 10-0.
Sherman still in quarterbacking. Everything's in tight. Got one wide to the right side, one set back. Kilpatrick in motion, left to right. They hand it to him. He's trying to turn that corner. He turns it. He's across the 35, the 40, almost out to the 45. I think they're going to say he finally got brought down about the 42, 43. So to bring out, what, second and?
Yeah, what's that, close to?
Second and 2.
Yeah, we'll give him second and 2.
I hate to use a sometimes overused word, but he is very elusive. I mean, he's got guys all around him, and he's pushing, using not really a stiff arm, but literally using his arm to throw him and shed those tacklers that are first trying to make attempts on him. That's why he's getting positive yards every time.
And it's not that big and bulky of a person to be doing that.
I know.
And got the motion right to left, but this time we're going to hand back off to the fullback. McGahey going up the middle. He's got the first down and then some. He's going to be right straight down in front of us on the 50-yard line.
Yeah, good hard run in that time, of course, by McGahee. Picks us up another first down. We're now at 36 seconds to go in the quarter, and we're already up 10 points. I tell you, beginning about the second half last week and so far into this week, we're in our offensive line seems to really be driving off the football now. They, too, seem now to be playing with a purpose. And, of course, it's that time of year now we're hitting region play, and it's time to come together and get this thing rolling, which it seems like we're doing now.
Yeah, we've got it all in there tight except for the one wide out. And this time, Sherman's dropping back to pass and dumps it off with the receiver still going downfield. Almost hits him in the back. Was that a get rid of it to avoid the sack? Or?
Well, what it looked like to me, it looked like to me that Banks was going down that way. And then all of a sudden, Ursel kind of was cutting up from behind him. I'm just thinking Ursel maybe should have cut that, you know, broke that off. From where he threw it, and then how close he was going to end up being
was that
to Tyler
kind of
out there.
Supposed to be a pick and roll kind of pattern.
Something just just a little out in the flat, and they're down to clear it for him.
All right, the ball's been handed off, but I don't know who's got
Jones over there. On the, he's not. I noticed, and that's good. It's hard to follow, but Jones got it, and he's going to pick up about maybe a yard there.
I saw him get the snap, and then everything started moving at that perfect angle where you couldn't see.
Yeah.
And at the conclusion of the first quarter of play, Lincoln County is up 10-0. We have the ball and are driving it. We got a touchdown and a field goal out of our first two possessions, and let's see what we can get out of this one. Just give a quick read down on the sponsors for your Lincoln County Football Network. Got Clyatt's Crossing Convenience Store, State Farm Insurance of Lincoln, and Johnson Equipment Repair and Rentals. Lincoln and Auto Sales, Verizon Wireless and Radio Shack of Lincoln. Turner Realty, Commercial Insurance Services Incorporated, Lincoln and Marine, R&W Auto Parts. Augusta Telephone Sales and Service, Cox Brothers Builders, Rail EMC, Golf DL, H&H Industries, Spratlin Hardware, and our injury report timeouts are brought to us by the American Academy of Manual Medicine and FMM Bank of Lincoln, a member of FDIC, are our sponsors on your Lincoln County Football Network.
And once again, Pete fixed us up a little snack pack from down at Grill DL, which is at
Grill
just
DL.
Where it is. It's at Golf DL.
Golf DL.
So when you can, give Pete a visit. We appreciate him fixing us up some hot wings, chicken wings, potatoes, all kind of goodies up here.
If you're looking for a little something different at lunch, go down there.
It's pretty cool. Yeah, I think you'll enjoy
what it was I got down at the catfish sandwich, I think it was.
The catfish hoagie or something like
catfish
that.
Catfish hoagie.
Yeah.
With some hush puppies on the side. Very good. All right. And it's going to be a pass play out to number one. He's got a reception, got the ball, going downfield, breaking tackles, getting away from folks. He's at the 10, the 5, and pushed.
On the one.
Out of bounds at the 1 foot line. I mean, he hits the pylon as he steps out.
Yeah, that was Kilpatrick again. We throw that little screen. You can call it like a tunnel screen, I guess it is. And boy, did he show us a lot of speed, but just could not quite get to the pylon. They go, it looks like, mark him on about the foot line. So we'll have it first and goal from just inches outside the goal line, and we're already up 10-0 with 11:47 to go now in the half. Good call there by the offense, and we went 49 fast yards.
And we're going with that full house backfield. Morris McGahee, and is it going to be a Sherman keeper?
Yeah, but there they go, touchdown.
Yeah, Sherman kept it winning off of left guard.
So at 11:42 to go in the second quarter.
Scored again, looking. So looking pretty smooth, like an offensive machine that we were hoping for this year, and begins to look like we may just be that. Remember, we're off next week, and then we've got Washington Wilkes 2 weeks from tonight up there.
The bragging right game. Snaps there. Kick is up. Kick is good. Walker kicks good.
Wow. You know, I ain't into the jinx stuff, so I guess I can talk about it. You know, this is our sixth game of the year, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
And we've only missed one PAT, and that was due to that, you know, I think, well, there's jumping over the line.
Yeah, that came over the center. You're exactly right.
Yeah, and we've only missed one, so
I was just going. I don't. You guys may know this. I was made aware of it talking to Vernon down here. Desmond Kilpatrick. This is his first year playing football.
I did not know that.
He's been a basketball player, great athlete, and Vernon says he's a great kid. I mean, just really good attitude. But this is his first year playing football, and no wonder we hadn't seen him before now. Yeah. He hadn't been out here. But with that, those kind of skills, man, he is. Yeah. I wish he'd been playing a couple more years.
I guarantee you. Wow. Well, good deal. Thank you, Dan, for that info. Man, that's pretty cool. Pretty good story there.
Walker Smith getting ready to kick off yet again. It's going to be kind of a mid-height one. It's going to be fielded at about the 15 by Aquinas. The guy's going to break it off to the right side. And we're going to stop him, looks like, right about the 30.
You know, and that's pretty good. If you got to go anywhere from 70 yards back to score, that's pretty good job. You know, that's kind of what you're looking for in high school. Anything backward is a plus. So we're at 11:34 to go now in the half. And we're up now 17-0.
But you know, you're talking about Kilpatrick. I was just thinking a while ago, like, it'd be great to get a big lead here so we can get the backups in.
Exactly.
Half of our starters are what you truly would call backups. Some of them
you're
got
right.
their first
we're very
varsity snaps last week after AG went down.
Right, exactly right.
Aquinas is going to hand off to the set back in the backfield, trying to go straight up the middle and barely gets back to the line of scrimmage, if that much.
Yeah, I see Kreid in there, and then there's one more number I'm trying to get. It may be McGahee, yeah. They stuff him right there at the line, so he's not going to pick. Hey, go give him about a foot maybe at the most. So it's going to be second down, and we go call it 9.5. They just moved it outside their 30-yard line. 11 minutes to go in the half. 17-0 at halftime. Don't forget to stay with us at halftime for our homecoming show.
Formation for Aquinas. Second and 10. It's going to be a little option play. Quarterback decides to keep it, cut back against the grain, and he's going to pick up about 4 yards out of it. You know, he takes it kind of a little option move, coming to our left. Sees a little seam back to the right side and picks up a little bit of positive yards for him.
Keldrick Cunningham did a good job there on backside pursuit coming down the line and met him there where he was trying to cut it back up.
So it's going to be third, and we're going to call it 6 for Aquinas on their own. 34-10-25 to go in the half. We're up 17 points.
Aquinas got wide outs either side, I formation. Lincoln County in a four-man front. Quarterback steps back. Dumps one off over in the right flats for an incomplete. It's going to bring up fourth and 6 with the ball in the Aquinas 35.
If he had caught that ball, I believe Ursel Daniel would have lit him up. It was one of those where I think he heard the footsteps and got some alligator arms.
Well, you know, and Aquinas isn't keeping the ball very long.
No.
I mean, you know, they giving it right back to
us. It's a bad situation where your offense is getting tired. That's what you like to hear. That means the offense has been out there a lot. Punts away. It's a good high one. It's going to be fielded this time at the 30 by Daniel. And he's going to take off to the far sideline. And he's got the wall. He's at the 50, to 40, to 30. One man. And he is down and in. Everything cool. No yeller on the field.
No yeller. We go, close to 70 yards.
70-yard punt return.
Woo.
By 24.
He Daniel. Wanted to give offense a break.
So, at 9:52, we're on the board yet again.
That's 2 for Ursel this year. Remember, he took, I think, the first time he touched it against Greene County and scored on the punt return. And now scores again here on homecoming night. I'm guessing it was some 65 or 70 yards. I really kind of wasn't watching necessarily where he fielded it. But they set up a beautiful wall.
Yes, they did. Walker Smith getting set to kick.
Mm-mm, did he get
it's
it in
a little
there?
Wobbly one, and it's going to be
wide. Hooked it. Yeah.
Kick no good. Not through
so
the
So maybe
upright.
That jinx stuff does
yeah,
work.
Yeah, he been talking.
I wasn't
going to
say, but I'm sitting there thinking, you just jinxed him.
But, you know, he thumped that thing pretty good. He just must have just pulled
it looked
that
like he
thing.
Looked like he got a little more toe instead of the side of the foot, you know. Mm. Just the angle I was looking at, looked like he kind of got it. Just a little bit too square with his toe instead of.
You never talk about a streak in process.
All right, well, we just started another one now. All right, here we go. We're up 23-0 with 9:52 to go until halftime. And remember to stay with us, and we will announce to you
who we will talk to you about the homecoming candidates.
Yes, and then we will tell you who won.
You will find out how
coming queen.
What not to describe what they're wearing? We are.
Yes, exactly.
Not what not to wear, but what not for us to describe. And Smith kicks off. It's going to be another little short blooper. It's going to bounce in front of the 21. Fill it at the 18. Comes to our side. Stutter steps, brought down at the 32. Seems like Aquinas has been starting everything right around the 30-yard line.
I see look like Rusty Scott getting up and Mickens getting up from the tackle there over here right next to us, and they'll take over on their own 30, like you said, on about their own 32. 9:44 until halftime. Lincoln County now on top, 23-0. What was that tape? Was it Thompson last week that scored 50-something or 60-something points? It was like one of the biggest outputs that they've ever had with Coach Welch there, Luther Welch.
Lincoln County in the five-man front. Aquinas in the shotgun. In the eye, drops back, fakes a little pass, and hands it off to his tailback. Going up the middle, picks up a couple yards.
Pick up about, looks like about five.
You know, Aquinas actually put, I think it was 54 points up last week themselves against Glasscock.
Yep. That time it looked like we had a guy on him, and one of our guys knocked our first tackle off, you know, guy that was going to make the tackle off, and he picks up 4 yards for Aquinas. Second and six. We're up 23 points.
Aquinas in the eye again. Got wide to either side. Lincoln County in a 4-3 defense. And they're trying to draw us off sides, but what's the whistle about?
Timeout
Aquinas. They were trying to go with that long, hard count, and it didn't work, so they called time on second down. But that's all right.
There you go.
So quit yawning.
We'll get you a couple of commercial breaks in that we weren't able to get to you through the pregame. So we'll be with you, back with you in just a second. If we can get things rigged up here. Be with you right back in just a moment.
Augusta Telephone Sales and Service. Quality service since 1983. Servicing all types of equipment. Call Augusta Telephone Sales and Service at 800-867-4777.
Turner Realty is a unique and experienced homegrown firm. Small enough to give you unmatched personal service, but large enough to meet your every real estate need. Call Turner Realty of Lincoln, Georgia at 1-888-805-8087. Johnson Equipment Company sells, service, and rental of equipment. They also provide on-site repair service. Call Ron or Jim at 706-359-1160. Johnson Equipment Company, Augusta Highway, Lincoln and Georgia.
Okay, with the timeout there, Aquinas hopefully has got that big game-busting play. Lincoln County in the 4-3 defense, and Aquinas is just going to hand off to the setback, going straight up the middle. Maybe picks up a yard or two. Going to bring up about 3.5 yards.
So there, third and 3.5, maybe four. We're down to 8:45 in the half. 23-0 Lincoln County.
You got a buzz in my ear. What'd you do different?
It's just this cord.
Oh, okay.
See if you unplug it. No buzz.
No buzz.
Plug it. Buzz.
Buzz. Got a buzz on here.
Look
out. Buzz up here. Third and three. Aquinas, quarterback, three-step drop back pass. Kind of a quick down and in, little pattern, about 5 yards down, but it's going to be for an incompletion. Quarterback's throwing just a little bit faster than the receivers can close their hands.
Yep. I mean, once again, he hit him and
he
just
him.
Couldn't hang on. He was fixing to take a pretty good pop, though. But
yeah, that one will test your will.
Hey, exactly, coming across the middle like that. So Aquinas is going to punt it.
I think they're going to punt it out of bounds. No, he's going to punt another high one. It's going to be a fair catch call for by Daniel at the 26, and that's where we'll start this possession.
Yeah. So we're at 8:13 to go in the half, 23-0 Lincoln County, and we've got the ball yet again.
With 8:13 to go to the half, Lincoln County up 23-0.
Yep, and probably, I'm sure, going to be looking for more. Now, this hopefully may be a game, though. I know what you're saying. Our guys are so young, but maybe can get some of those second and third stringers in.
And we'll have to see. McGahee to set back. One set back, wings on either side. Sherman's still under there. And it's going to hand off to Daniel, going in motion from right to left. And he's got the lane. He's got the corner turn. He's got open field. One man giving chase and cannot catch him.
63-yard touchdown. 73-yard touchdown run. Wow, there goes Ursell again.
8:01 to go in the half.
Man, you know that 24 is awful close to that 25, and that looks familiar right there.
Yeah, he hit a crease over on the left side. We put him in motion, and next thing you know, he's in for another touchdown with just 8 minutes to go. All right, Walker, let's get our streak going back to now, man.
Start back over with one.
Yeah.
Snaps there, kicks up.
There you go, partner. And he drilled that one too. A little bit of anger with that one. So that was a one-play drive that went 73 fast yards.
The total yardage in two plays, Daniel's got, what, about 143?
You know, that is one way to keep your offense fresh.
Just one play.
Yeah.
Is, you know.
29 to nothing.
So you know what this means could happen in the third and fourth quarters. They could speed this thing up rapidly.
Yep. And we will probably get another score this half.
Probably so. So, Walker's getting a good workout tonight. He can't complain that he hadn't saw enough action tonight. We've scored more points tonight than we have all year, I think. Yeah.
There's our boy Dylan kick extra points.
I think so. So he may get a shot tonight.
We may see him with some action.
Yeah.
Second
half. Uh-oh.
And it's a kickoff. It's going to drop at about the 15. Nobody's there to pick it up. Rolls back to the 5. Aquinas finally picks it up there. And their receiver is cutting it across here and tries to cut back in on the 15. And I guess that line marker just tripped him up.
That Smurf will get you every time.
It slipped up on the line, I guess, because that's where he went down.
There was a little confusion that time. You know, they kind of had two guys, you know, back deep. And Walker just split the difference, and neither one of them really, I don't know if they didn't want it, but. Finally, one guy went and picked it up, and he returns it out to the 16 where they'll take over. First and 10, 7:50 to go in the half. We're now up 30 to nothing.
Aquinas got first and 10 with the ball at the 15. Got 85 yards to go to get on the board. And they're going to continue to run in plays. And sometime, who was that came through and just put a pop on that guy?
Looked like McGahee. Looked like maybe looked like Crite maybe kind of had him around the legs. Next thing you know, just McGay. I'm thinking it was him just plowed him down. But he does pick up about 2 yards. Gilly said he got 3 yards. But I'm like, stretching that
one. The down marker says 2.
Yeah, so just because you got a better view than we did him.
It was 2, Gil.
All right, second down for Aquinas. Yeah, we'll split the difference with him.
All right. Like you can in a four-man front on defense. Going to hand to the set back in the back, and he's going to go up the middle, picking up 3 or 4 yards. You down.
Once again, old McGahee kind of making them cats pay for it when they get
up.
You're
down 30 points, and you're trying to grind it up the middle.
Well, you know, you may be trying to run the clock.
That's what I'm saying.
I mean, you know,
there's got to be a rhyme or reason to this.
Yeah, third down, and we'll say – 2.5 or 3 for Aquinas.
The thing I don't get is it's the same looking play.
Yeah, same play.
Nothing like, about it has changed.
Their playbook is the back of a gum wrapper.
Just tell how it is, man.
Well, it's three plays.
Yeah,
I
understand.
All you've seen.
And they call time. So with that, if you'll give us just a moment, we'll take some more commercial breaks, and we'll be back in just a few moments on the Lincoln County Football Network.
F&M Bank is a proud sponsor of Lincoln County Football. So why don't you go by today and see Gil at F&M Bank. They're located at 317 South Washington Street, right here in Lincoln, Georgia. Or you can give them a call at 706-359-6283. For all your banking needs, go see Gil at F&M Bank right here in Lincolnton.
Football season means winter is on the way. Be prepared with the help of Spratlin Hardware in Lincoln and a full-service hardware and building supply store. Spratlin Hardware carries Owens Corning insulation to keep your home warm and cozy. A full line of electrical and plumbing supplies, cut glass and mirrors. They stock Gelwin doors and M high-tech lock, Glidden paints and supplies. They've been in business over 85 years, and they thank their many customers for their support and will continue offering competitive prices with anybody, including Augusta. Spratlin Hardware, Peachtree Street in Lincoln and your Owens Corning dealer.
Aquinas called the timeout with third and two. 6:26 to go to the half. Lincoln County up 30 to nothing. And Aquinas drops back, fakes the handoff to a setback, gets a pass off. It's a reception, and he's brought down immediately, but I think he's going to be, he's got the first.
Yeah. They go from the, what, the 24 out to about the 20, 28. Yeah, they pick up about 4 or 5 yards. First completion of the night for Aquinas. They'll have it first down. We're headed down to 6 minutes to go in the half, and we're up 30 points.
Aquinas sending two receivers out to the left side. Still got that eye formation. Lincoln County running that four-man front, looking for him to pass. Quarterback drops back, acts like a pass. Then he does a little handoff to his fullback, goes tailback, going off that left guard tackle spot. Picks up about two. I think they may be just trying to do a little ball control. Let's get some first downs.
Yeah, just, you know,
and
keep
don't,
it from getting.
Don't give them the ball back so they can't score again before the half.
I mean, really, yeah, exactly. So it'll be second down and eight. The ball now touching their own 30. 5:35 to go in the half, and your Red Devils are up tonight 30 to nothing. Stay with us at halftime tonight, and we'll let you know who our homecoming queen 2009 is.
Back in the shotgun, two backs with the quarterback. And they're going to do a little fake inside handoff. Quarterback keeps it going around the right side for a no gainer. Well, maybe a yard or two.
Yeah, he's going to pick up just a couple, I think. Yeah, they're going to mark him two. Going to be second down and actually a long five.
Keeps the ball inbounds, keeps the clock running.
Actually,
we're under
six.
5 minutes.
Third down, 6 yards to go.
And we're on top tonight, 30 to nothing. Boy, we've had five intense weeks of football.
Yeah.
This is kind of enjoyable, I ain't going to lie to you.
The first breather we've had all season.
Yeah,
basically.
Exactly. And, you know, but, you know, that makes you stronger in the end, too, though.
And this is region play right
here.
First
this
game,
is it.
First season, region game of the season. Aquinas back in the shotgun. They got third and five. We got a bunch of folks on the line. Looks like we're going to put pressure on him. He fakes an inside handoff, gets the pass off, in and out of the hands of the receiver, and a interception by number eight, Sherman, going around left side, and he's going to get brought down at about the 30 of Aquinas.
And actually, Doug, hit the receiver again. I mean, I know they're a little high, but still, you got to make that catch. But a good job by Sherman sitting back there in center field and concentrated enough to it come – you know, skidding off his hands into Franklin's hands, and it's intercepted by Sherman and returned to their 30.
And basically what's happening, just an analogy, he's throwing the ball, say, 30 miles an hour. They're closing the hands at 20 miles an hour.
It just
ain't connected.
Yeah.
They both got to be in sync.
He's not throwing bad passes.
He's putting the passes there, just that receiver's just not quick enough to bring it in. And Moore is in at quarterback now, and he throws a pass out on the left side. Got a reception, couldn't tell who had it.
Jones.
Yep.
We're going to pick up down to the 25-yard line, pick up five on that little quick hitter. Did he get out of bounds? Yeah, he must have. 4:03 to go. He got out of bounds. We're on there 25 now. It looks like we're really going to try to score again before the half.
Moore back in the shotgun. Got a setback with him. Two receivers either side. He's driving back, looking, throws out in the flats to McGahee for an incompletion on his fingertips.
Yeah, that time Garrett had a good idea to get it to him quick, but led him just about a step maybe too much. And
he had plenty of room over there. If he just puts a nice little toss up there instead of gunning it, it just led him with it.
Just a little lob to him to come up under.
So we're third and five on their 25. and see what we'll run. Now we're with Garrett in. We're running the spread, and we go just looks like try to throw it a little bit. And it's okay to work on this stuff. You need to work on it, you know.
You may have to go to it.
Yep.
Morris is set back with Moore back there. Moore looking, got time. Throws down to the corner. He's got a receiver down there.
Touchdown.
Number 15, Devontae Wright.
And boy, did he throw that on a string or what?
What was the distance on that?
25 yards. Boy, Garrett throws a bullet for a touchdown. He kind of locked in him the whole way, and their guys really looked like kind of when it got toward the goal, quit. And Devontae just kept going and caught a strike for Moore.
You want to know something funny?
Yeah.
That wasn't a play to sideline call.
Oh, is that right?
He misread or got the wrong thing from him.
Off his wristband?
Yep.
And the extra point is good.
We'll just keep misreading the wristband, I guess, if we misread it. We're now up 37-0 with 3:49 to go until the half. Finally, a breather, it looks like. Looks like we'll get to call some names that we hadn't got to call all year, perhaps in the second half.
Those wristbands, I'm still trying to sort them. I guess because you hadn't got dirt on the field, you can have it right there and have a little wiper board on your arm. And
There you go.
But actually, the drawn out are I've never looked at them.
Everything's numbered. So you just, they're given a number. You look at your number on the wristband, it tells you what play it is.
Okay.
Well, what if, like, you were supposed to wear reading glasses and you ain't got
then you're in trouble. You need to be sitting up in the booth and not out on the field.
I guess so. Unless you
the one like that looks like he's out there chasing butterflies all over.
Yeah.
And Smith getting set to kick off yet again. Another line drive kick that's going to be fielded by Aquinas at the 15 on the far side. Comes across midfield. Still coming our side. Got a little lane. Gets it out to the 40. That's probably about the best field position.
Yeah, maybe.
I know it's the best they've started with. Maybe the best they've had all night, is it?
I believe you're right. Did they cross? No, they didn't cross midfield yet, I don't think. They got close, I hit to the 45 or something, maybe something like that. So, anyway, Aquinas will take over first and 10 on their own 40. We're at 3:39 and a half, and we're up 37 points.
All right, let's get the clock going. Let's go to half. Aquinas. Back in the eye, Lincoln County's got the five-man front on defense. Aquinas look like they're almost toe-to-toe up on that line. Real tight line formation, going straight up the middle with a handoff. And this time they get a little push by everybody on the team, pushing the running back about 5 yards.
Yeah, a little bit of a surge over here on that left-hand side. Looks like Crite getting up again from the bottom of the pile. They're going to almost pick up six, but we'll...
Kind of everybody was bunched up there, moving in the same
direction,
and the back had no place to fall.
Exactly. I know he couldn't go down nowhere, could he?
He was looking for a soft landing spot and couldn't find it.
We're at 3 minutes to go in the half, and the Red Devils are on top 37-0.
Quines puts... Got three receivers on the right side, shotgun formation, one set back, nobody on the left side, and he hands to his set back, going back up the middle again.
Yep, picks up about 4 yards, and before we get him down, it looks like Morris is getting up off the bottom of that pile. It's going to be third and one for Aquinas with 2:30 to go in the half, 37-0 Lincoln County tonight. On a beautiful night for football.
If you really want to catch us off guard, throw a deep pass right now. Don't go for the short yard. Go for a deep pass.
Go for the gusto.
Go for it. Still got fourth down to come back and pick up your 1 yard. But he's going to quarterback sneak it, and I don't know. It will be close.
I don't think he will be short.
He's going to be short, according to the official that's stepping up on my side.
Boy, are they generous.
That is an awfully generous mark.
That mark is crazy.
I still don't think
he's still short. The stick is on the far side of the 50. He's short of
the line, the 4-inch, you know, the line they mark off across there is.
Yeah.
They're going to call. They're going to say he got, whoa.
That's what I'm saying. That was.
Okay, that's right. It's fourth down.
Fourth down.
Fourth and an inch, 2 inches.
Whoa, he's no struggle.
He got it. Quarterback sneak, almost didn't get it.
He wouldn't have got it without the help of a tailback pushing him.
Somebody came up and pushed him.
So they pick up a first down, and that's kind of been maybe just their second or third all night. The half is getting late. We had a minute 29 to go. We're on top 37-0, and the clock now begins to run.
Okay, here comes the contestants across here. This.
Yeah.
With their escorts all dressed up. All right, Aquinas puts a man in motion left to right. He's got receivers all over the place. It's going to be a little double reverse. Flip back to the quarterback. Throws downfield. He's got a receiver at the 35, and he may get in and score. Oh, let's see. No, he goes out of bounds.
We got a flag. I don't know if we're holding on the offense.
Holding Aquinas way back up here.
Wow.
Great play call. A little double reverse flip. Triple.
That was pretty
double reverse, flip back to the quarterback.
You know, you had said something like that a while ago, what, third and one, but they waited and got a first down, and really a beautiful play, but they were holding us in order to get the play off. And, Doug.
They ran 10 dive plays up the middle to set that up.
I may be wrong, but that is the first hanky of the night.
Oh, okay.
And actually, it's going to be about a 15-yard penalty. Actually, it's about a 60-something-yard penalty. Boy, don't that hurt. You finally get
a
little bit of
I don't know that the hole had any effect
any
on that
effect,
play.
Yeah. I mean, once again, I didn't see it, so I don't know how bad it was. But, man, that was a pretty play.
Yeah.
That was a pretty play. They ran on us and almost scored, but they're back now, way back to their 36-yard line. 53 seconds to go in the half, 37-0 Lincoln County.
And they got two receivers left, one to the right, one set back, quarterback up under center. We're in a 4-2 defense right now. Quarterback, four-step drop back, throws across the middle, incomplete, throws into double coverage.
Yep, that'll bring up second down and about 25 or so to go. 49 seconds to go until halftime, and we're still up by the skin of our teeth. 37 of
skin
them.
About chinny, chinny,
37 chinny. Skins. 37 after the Lincoln camp. What is the skins?
That's a golf game. Skins.
Yeah, you do. You right.
All right, eye formation for Aquinas. Quarterback steps back, pumps up, drops down, hands off, and they pick up about 10 yards out of it.
Close to 10.
They just want to run this clock out and go into half with just a 37-point deficit.
I believe you're right, my friend.
Anything but 40 is success. And our offense and special teams has really played good out here tonight.
Exactly. I agree with you 100% there.
And Aquinas, if their receivers catch half the passes that have been right in their hands, they've got some drives going. And the eye formation again, hands off to the setback, tail back, and he gets it back to the line of scrimmage. And that's that all-important halftime buzzer.
There it is.
Halftime homecoming coming up. 37-0, Lincoln County.
All right, we'll keep it right here.
Let's open this window so I can hear what they're saying across the field to match up with what I'm saying.
All right, we can do that, my little friend.
And they'll be introducing the homecoming court.
Taylor Duke, treasurer of the junior class and secretary of student council. On behalf of the Lincoln County Board of Education, Superintendent Dr. Raymond Edwards, and Principal Dr. Becky Barden, and the faculty, staff, and student body of Lincoln County High School, I would like to welcome the Buddy Buffers.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. All right, it is homecoming here, and we are waiting on them to start introducing those young ladies so we can.
Local DJ Jason Crook will DJ tonight's dance. Flowers for the homecoming floor were purchased from Jericho Florence and Gifts, and the crowns for tonight's homecoming contest were purchased from Tina Jewelry and Gifts in Washington. A very special thing
All right, right now they've got the freshman homecoming court folks, and that's Ashley Aspel is the first one going out there with looks like a black pantsuit. And Dan, if you're across the field over there, you can help me out because all I'm looking at the backside here. And the other freshman class representative is Chelsea Norman. Looks like she's got on a black dress with some kind of a purple top. And that's looking about, let's see, what's that, 100 yards across the field, and I can see 20, 22. What you see at 20 feet, I can see it too. Where you at, Dan? You got to help me out. Representing the sophomore class is Hannah Bryant. And she's in a black and white printed dress would look like black boots from way over here. You up here chowing down on the golf restaurant deal snacks. And also representing the sophomore class is Hannah Holloman. And black slacks and a black and white printed top. I said, this is strange, having to look across the field and try to figure out who's who and not even seeing faces. Hopefully the PA system's coming through and you can pick up some of this stuff they're saying about them. She also participates in the youth group at First Assembly of God. Hannah B. is born tonight by her brother, Joshua Holland. Junior, Elizabeth Conley. And the junior's homecoming court is Liz Dunaway. Escorted by her father, Tut. Liz is in a purple dress. Or it could be a jacket from here. Also representing the junior class is Tierra Wynn. And in the gray skirt, black top with look like black boots, long sleeve top. No. Was I had it. All right, the first senior contestant is Audra Bradford, escorted by her father, Bill Bradford. And I can't tell what she got. Whatever it is, it's got
it's
some
kind of shiny
stuff.
Yeah,
looks like some. Looks like it could be a black dress with some silver sequins or something of that in it. I believe she works at El Poro Mexican
Restaurant. Yeah, like she does, yeah.
Always has a smile on her face up there.
Yeah, sweet girl.
It ain't wimpy, it ain't hot.
Dick around and got him a wing and then got hot.
I didn't think they were hot.
I didn't either. He may have got a hot one, though. I don't know.
The next homecoming candidate is Elise Brown, escorted by her father, Tim Brown. Yeah, it seems like the dominant color for his dresses is the black and white type stuff. She's got on the black skirt with the white printed type top.
She's about the most gullible.
Okay.
That's pretty cool.
Dan, if you ever put your headset back on, you can chime in anytime. You can tell us what they're wearing from where you're standing. He done went on vacation on me over there. Hattie Collins, being escorted by her grandfather, Stanton Collins. Stanton Tankersley, my bad. And Hattie's got on the black slacks and a kind of a grayish black top. Parts of it looks gray, parts of it looks black. Under the arms and down the sides is black, and across the back and down around the waist is grayish looking. Who you think's going to win? Can't say.
Don't want to show no bias, do we?
The one with the most votes.
Yeah.
The one with the next most votes.
Do they still do it like when we were, when I was in? The student body votes?
I think.
Yeah, that's.
I don't know. And the next contestant is Jade Deason, escorted by her father, Timmy Deason. And she's got on one of them black and white, but it's checkerboard looking.
Yeah.
Diagonal checkerboard. That makes sense. It ain't squared across. It's the diamond
like a
shape.
Diamond shape.
Checkerboard. And either black hose or black leggings or black pants under there. I can't tell.
We turned out a pretty good crowd out here tonight.
Yep. Stands look kind of full. A little bit of standing room around the fences. Not quite a wash and whoops kind of thing on our side, but as far as the stands, they did fill them up tonight. Mm-hmm. And Aquinas brought a pretty good little crowd. All right. The next candidate is Shaman Hurst, escorted by her twin brothers, Daniel Cook and Raphael Cook. Well, it ain't but one of them out there. What happened? They messed me up. Shaman's got on the black skirt. Looks like it could be a black and brownish colored top. They're all standing out there anxiously waiting. Is it me? If it ain't me, I still got to put that. Oh, I'm so happy for you, smile.
I know you have. There you go.
All right, so it's Daniel Cook that. Also representing the senior class tonight is Emily Henson. And your next contestant is Emily Henson, escorted by her father, the Reverend Dave Henson. And Emily's got on, looks like a black skirt, purple top, and some black boots. Those knee-high boots seems to be the in thing this year for some reason. And the black skirts and black pants.
Now, I always thought homecoming night and senior.
Usually senior recognition goes
hand in hand.
They're doing senior recognition.
The last game. I guess they will since it will be.
It's going to be one of the other ones. Yeah, then they kind of figured out there was probably going to be the last game, the Warren County game, because that's our next home game.
Yeah.
And the next contestant is Marie Matthews, escorted by her father, Flint Matthews. Marie's got on the black pants and a white and black and white print jacket top.
She's my buddy.
Yep.
That's my buddy. She's about the most number of giggles, she just said.
And the next contestant is Hannah Mongru, escorted by her brother, Oliver Monroe. And short skirt and top, but I can't tell what color. It looked like it could be a deep purple or light black. So it makes sense. With boots. It looks, it's not black boots. It looked like it could be purplish or brownish.
Yeah, maybe brown, yeah.
Could be brown. It's hard to say.
We're going to have to invest in binoculars next year.
I meant to bring some.
You know, I didn't even think about it.
But it's a nice court of homecoming candidates and underclass court, homecoming court folks. And now we're getting close to the moment we've all been anxiously awaiting for. And 2008 Princess and Queen are going to be coming up to do the crowning. Amanda Broom was the princess last year. And the 2008 Homecoming Queen last year, Lindsay McWhorter, coming across, getting ready to do the presentations of the Queen and Princess. And you're going to have to listen carefully to see who wins what. Princess
2009. The 2009 homecoming princess is Shaman Hurst.
Shaman Hurst, the 2009 princess. Queen?
Marie Matthews.
It's the 2009 homecoming queen for Lincoln County. And she steps out there and gets her queen banner and crown. Being embraced by her father, Flint Matthews. So there you have it. Homecoming 2009, your king, queen.
I'm glad she got it, too.
So, Aquinas will take over first and 10, and they're down 37 points on their own 20-yard line.
Yeah, they did mark it back to 20. And if you're just joining us, it's 11:50, and it's 37-0 in the third quarter.
Wow.
Red Devils.
Man.
Who'd have thunk it?
Yeah.
I'm glad it's happening. All right, let's see. I'm looking. We still have pretty much starters. Yeah, we still got starters on defense. They're in an I formation, two wideouts to the right, quarterback's under center. He's going to take the snap, hand to the deep man. He's going to try to run up the middle, ditto. He's going to get some positive yards there, fight out to looks like the 24 maybe, depending on where they spot it. Yeah, he's going to be right around the 24, so we'll give him 4 yards on that, and they'll have second and six. But it's a long six.
Yeah. But that little 44, he drives his legs pretty good. You know, every time they pushed us back a few times, they actually in the first half had 63 yards rushing on us. So that isn't horrible to be down 37-0. You'd think maybe that may be even worse than that.
That's right. All right, Aquinas, I formation again, two wideouts right. Quarterback's under center, takes a snap. He hands to the deep man, and he's going to run to his right, and he's going to be met there quickly by big number 74, Marquise Parks. And he's going to drop him. Yeah, that's going to be right at the line of scrimmage. Mm-hmm. Well, Mark, they're going to give him a yard on that.
Yeah, give him out to the 25. Like you said, big Marquise just kind of did a stunt inside and ran right into the ball carry. Actually, he looked like he was going off right guard. And Marquise is our right tackle, but he makes the play and stops him for just a 1 yard gain, third and five.
What did you say about right guard? Yeah, I wore mine today. Oh.
Have you? Right guard.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, quarterback's going to be under center. Got I formation again, wide out left, wide out right. Quarterback is going to take the snap and going to fake to the deep man. He's looking to his left. We're in the backfield there with him. He just throws it away in the vicinity. And it'll be fourth down and five, and that's a three and out for the defense the first series.
Yep, that's kind of what we was wanting to see. And maybe we can get another score or two and see some of those guys that have been practicing some of those hot days and have yet, because of the closeness of all the games, just has not had the opportunity to get on the football field on a Friday night.
All right, they're in the punt formation to snap. Oh, we're going to get to him, and we unfortunately did not get a part of the ball, and we will rough the kicker there. Big Tavius McGay, he got back there and was in very much in the vicinity and had a chance at the ball, but unfortunately did not get it.
Yes, 15 yards. They're trying to say we touched it, but I don't.
He just hit it bad, I guess.
No, Gilly just said he just kicked it bad, I guess.
Yeah, Gilly's giving the official a hard time because the ball went nowhere, but the way it appeared to me, it looked like the punter turned to that side trying to avoid the rush. And he didn't kick it anywhere.
Coach Campbell's over here arguing that we touched the ball.
Oh.
But I don't think it's going to work.
Yeah, up 37
ball,
nothing.
Foul. Wow.
Yep.
Our fans are thrilled with the call, you can imagine.
Our first flag of the night is 15 yards out to the 40-yard line. Well, Qantas will take over. Not take over, but resume possession. And we're up 37 points with 10 to go in the third.
Right. Just gets us a chance to get a few more tackles.
Yeah, you pad the defensive stats a little.
All right, big shock. Aquinas is in the I formation. This time they have two wideouts to the left. Wow. Quarterback's under center. Going to take the snap, hand to the deep man, and he's going to run basically up the middle. But he's going to fight for some yards, but there was a hold in there. And he's going to get out to across the 40, inside the 40, down to about the 38-yard line. But I think that's coming back where that flag went down.
He'll pick up 22 yards unless it's nullified.
It will be nullified. Yep. I missed what he said. David, did you see what signal he gave? He was facing that direction, and I couldn't see. Was that illegal use of the hands or a hold?
Probably right in there, I'm going to guess.
Yeah, it was a hold.
Okay. That'll be a spot foul, so it really won't be first and 20. It's going to be more like first and 15. No, 14. First and 14.
So a 10-yard penalty, which that's two big plays Aquinas has had tonight that's been wiped out due to a penalty. They remember they got down to what about our three one time, and they were holding, and now they go 23 yards, and they get called for holding first. And what we'll call it, what, 12 or 13? The board says 14, so.
Yeah, where that ball is, it should be 14 because it was on the 40, and that's back almost all the way to the 36. All right, Aquinas is in the shotgun and got four wideouts, one back in the backfield. Man comes in motion from the right, and we jump and make contact, so I'm afraid we're going to give them back some yards, and they'll have a first and 8.5. So with 9:36 left to go in the third quarter, it is 37-0, good guys.
The only offense is flags. Offense and defense.
Right now we're trading hankies after. You had to go and say it. That was the first flag earlier in the second quarter.
They didn't have but one the whole first half.
One entire first half. We've already had, what, four now?
This is pretty good now. So first down and, I don't know, 8 maybe?
8.5.
Yeah.
And y'all be surprised. There's no food left from that food that came up from Golf DL here at the second half. I didn't get any. Thanks, guys. Oh,
well,
Aquinas is in the shotgun. Four wideouts. He's looking to his left. Got a little time. Tries to zip it across the middle and just out in front of his receiver. It'll fall incomplete. Be second down and that 8.5 again.
Well, look, because I like you so much, I'm going to tell you it was good. And now thank you, Pete, for fixing us some little snacks and sending them up here for us to kind of munch on during timeouts and halftime. And so when you get a chance, go down out to Golf DL and pick you up some lunch or dinner on Friday nights and Saturday nights.
All right, Aquinas has got four wideouts again, two left, two right, one back in the backfield, quarterback's in the shotgun. Man comes in motion, headed to his left, and the quarterback's going to take the snap. He's looking over there. They kind of throw a little screen of sorts there, quick out there, but he gets nothing. There's a flag, and where that was, again, it's got to be holding.
Yeah, I may return this one down, I think.
I don't know. I feel position.
He's declining it.
Is he?
Yeah.
Okay, well, see, you're a smarter fellow.
Well, me and Coach, we go way back.
Illegal motion.
Illegal motion, okay.
Hey, we'll give him a yard.
That flag came in late for a motion, but it that's what they call.
Yeah.
All right. Aquinas getting the signal from the sideline. The quarterback's looking over now. They're calling a timeout.
All right.
So we got timeout with 9:08 left to go in the third quarter. Red Devils up 37-0.
You want to read?
I will read some of our sponsors.
We just thank our sponsors. We appreciate them.
Clyde's Crossing Convenience Store. Thank you very much. Doug Newman, State Farm Insurance Agent. The Big Kahuna, we appreciate him. Johnson Equipment Repair and Rentals. Lincolnton Auto Sales. Verizon Wireless and Radio Shack of Lincolnton. Turner Realty. Commercial Insurance Services. Lincolnton Marine. R&W Auto Parts. Augusta Telephone Sales and Service. Cox Brothers Builders, Rail MC, Golf DL, H&H Industries, Spratland Hardware, American Academy of Manual Medicine, and F&M Bank of Lincolnton, member FDIC. Appreciate all our sponsors very much. They are the reason that we can be on the air. They are the reason that we're able to bring this to you, and we appreciate them so much. Again, it is 9:08 left to go in the third quarter. We're in a timeout here with the Red Devils up 37-0, and Aquinas has the ball with third and about 8.5 at the 42-yard line.
And in case you missed it, Miss Marie Matthews is our 2009 homecoming queen. So congratulations to her.
That's right. Congratulations, Marie. She goes to my church. We're real proud of her.
Good deal.
All right. They got two backs in the backfield. Quarterback in the shotgun. Two wideouts right, one left. Quarterback's rolling back, looking back to his left. Throws kind of behind the line. And he's going to be played very well right there by number 15.
Devontae. Yeah.
Devontae Wright going to drop him for a loss, and it'll be fourth down and, oh, let's say 11. And the Red Devils will get the ball back, theoretically.
Yeah, we're supposed to get it back. Anyway, we'll have to see. They've kept it for almost half a quarter. Well, when you get it back to back, you know.
That's right. All right, the snap. The kick is up, and it's a pretty decent kick. Urcell is going to watch it because they weren't sure what they were going to do. Oh, my goodness. We kind of dance around that. Which we could do on a punt and let it stop, but then finally Desmond Kilpatrick picks it up there, so we get no return out of that. It'll be stopped at the 29-yard line. We'll take over. No, 24-yard line, sorry. We'll take over here with 8:21 left to go in the third quarter, up 37-0.
Yeah, we put two guys back like they did on the kickoff a while ago, and he kind of split them, and both of them, I actually, neither one of them went for the ball. So, first and 10, Lincoln County on our own, 24-8, 8:21 to go in the third, and we're up 37 points.
Okay, Garrett is in at quarterback, and we do have most of the first string. There is a couple in there that aren't. Garrett's in the shotgun, takes a snap, steps up in the pocket, and he's going to tuck it down and run. He's going to get out to, he's going to get close to a first down, out to about the 34-yard line now before being stopped. Matter of fact, they're going to mark him, looks like, right at the 35. So that'll be first and 10 with 8:06 left to go in the third quarter. Your Red Devils up 37-0.
Yeah, a lot of times when, once you break that first wave of the rush, then you got a little bit of running room. And Garrett took advantage of it and sprinted out for 11 yards right up the middle. We'll have first and 10 on own 35, 7:50 to go in the third, and we're up 37 points.
All right, Red Devils break the huddle. We got two wideouts left, two wideouts right, one back in the backfield. Garrett's in the shotgun. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to his right. Throws out there to Rusty Scott. He catches at the 40, at the 45, out to the 50, across the 50, down to about the 47-and-a-half-yard line as we get into Aquinas territory with 7:34 left to go in the third quarter, up 37-0.
37-0. Exactly a 17-yard strike. And, boy, he put something. He put a little pepper on that one, too, to Rusty. And Rusty showed us some good running ability there with the ball. We had first and 10.
All right, Red Devils break the huddle. We're going to have two wideouts right, two wideouts left. Garrett's in the shotgun. Got Tavis in the backfield as the lone back with him. Now we're going to take the snap. He's looking to his left. Throws out there quickly to Tavis and had a little pressure. They're chasing the ball down as if it were not a forward pass, but it was very clearly a forward pass. So with 7:05 left to go in the third quarter, it's 37-0 Red Devils, and we have second down and 10.
Yeah, I don't know if that ball was tipped, but it just something, throwed it off. But that time he was trying to do what we talked about earlier, just give him a little air under, but it may have been tipped. I couldn't quite tell. Second down and 10.
All right. Once again, we come out with four wideouts, but this time three to the left, one to the right, one back in the backfield. The back in the backfield, Stephen Morris alongside Garrett. Garrett's in the shotgun. He's going to take the snap. He's looking left. Steps up in the pocket, steps up. Now he's going to tuck it down and run. He's going to get down to the 45, down to the 40, and he's going to be dropped, just around the 38-yard line maybe. Hard to tell.
He's going to get close to a first down. He's going to pick up about 9 yards. I saw Sagas out there doing a good job blocking for him. He's going to be mighty close to a first down.
Yeah, they have to measure this. Yep, the official's going to call timeout with 6:40 left to go in the third quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. We're going to have a measurement here to see if we did indeed get the first down.
All right, first measurement of the night, I guess it is.
You know, our chain gang's taking it across. That's Mark McKinney and Marcus Spratlin on the sticks, and we got Rusty who does the line, and then Big Jim Madison doing a down marker. Oh, yes, call it first down. Got to be. Oh, ain't no way that thing's short. If that's short, that's
just
short.
Frog here.
By how much, David?
1 inch.
1 inch.
Oh, man.
Migration. All right, we're going to have second down and an inch. Or is it going to be third down?
It'll be third.
Third down, that's right. That's right.
6:40 to go in the third, and the score is?
37-0.
All right.
Red Devils.
Red Devils on top tonight, so. Any minute, I'm expecting to start watching some of these second and third stringers get in. And it'll be kind of fun to watch some of those guys. Congratulations to our JV yesterday. They won big, wasn't it?
41-27, I believe, is what I heard over Greenbrier.
So David was telling me today, so who was it had four touchdowns for us?
David will have to tell us that. I don't remember.
Yeah, we'll get him to tell me.
Megan.
Sagas.
Sagas had – He had four. One of them was called back. I forgot about that.
Okay.
One of them was
right.
called
Throws
back.
Throws out the Sagas. And the man on third and short. Wow. Okay. Well, we can get it on fourth down, I guess.
If we can't get an inch, then so be it. Tried to run one of those little tunnel screen looking things to Mason, and just didn't happen, did it?
Yeah, just threw it a little in front of him. And
just got nothing going on that.
Tried to get it out there nice, but we didn't quite connect there, so we'll have fourth and a frog here.
Yeah,
with 6:27 left to go.
Some of
the
folks
quarter.
Have decided to go on to the house early tonight, haven't they?
Yeah, well, some of them do come for the homecoming
leave. Yeah.
All right, Garrett's under center. He's going to take the snap. He's going to go right up the middle, and he's going to actually get way more than enough, and he's going to be almost out to the 35. He's going to be at the 36-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 with 6:15 left to go in the third quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. And it's just a beautiful night tonight. The air is very, very comfortable. There's no breeze to speak of at all. The flag's just laying limp right now. Great night for football.
And if you could take this into November and December, it'd be nice, wouldn't it?
All right, the Red Devils got two wideouts right, two wideouts left, one back in the backfield. Garrett's in the shotgun. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to his left, throws out there quickly to Craig Jones. Craig is going to take it and run. He's got some room out there, gets inside the 20-yard line down to about the 17, it would appear. So another first down with 5:40 to go in the third quarter. Red Devils up 37-0.
Pick up about 19 yards on a quick popper out to Jones. And what Jones – just a sophomore. We are really playing a lot of young guys this year, which is good for years to come.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
So we're first and 10 now on their, 16 or 17-yard line.
All right. Garrett's in the shotgun. Two wideouts left, two wideouts right, one back in the backfield. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to his right. Steps up. There's a little pressure. Steps up again. He's going to tuck the ball and run, and this time he's going to get down. Inside the 15-yard line, hard to tell where that spot is. It's inside maybe 14, maybe almost to the 13. Jim looks like he's going to put the marker at the 13, but he's not the official. It's going to be 13 and a half, we'll call it.
14, Gilly said he got four.
So with under 5 minutes left to go in the first
quarter. He's right inside the 15.
Okay, thank you, Big
I hate to correct y'all.
Hey, we appreciate it. You can see gooder than we can from there. bad grammar intended.
Yeah,
sorry.
My eyes are a little younger.
Hey, wait, we didn't have to go that.
Very little.
I didn't mind the correction
Very
part.
Very little. All right, Garrett's in the shotgun, wide out right, two wide outs left. Throws batted down.
No, yeah. I think that was just an ugly throw. I mean, you know.
Thought he was going to try to get that out to Bon Turner, and I think he actually threw it over to Craig Jones. Don't know what happened there. What happened, David? Did you see that? We were kind of
It's almost like it stuck
there.
To his hand or something.
It just, yeah, it was just low. Okay. Just low throw, bad throw.
Thank you very much. All right. We are 4.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. It is third, and we'll call it six, a long six. And Garrett is in the shotgun again. Two wideouts right, two wideouts left. Tavis is in the backfield alongside Garrett. Snap comes, kind of low, looking to his left, throws, gets knocked down by one of their linebackers. Had Tyler over there open, but couldn't quite get it to him. And I guarantee that kid that knocked it down is probably about 6'4".
I was going to say, that cat's 9 foot tall, man. I mean, he jumped up, made a real good play. It's like we had Scott maybe open on a little curl, but we're going to go for it here on fourth down. 4:20 left to go into third, and it's 37-0.
All right, let's see what we bring at him again. I guess we're going to have another one of these spread sets. Two wideouts right, two wideouts left. Tavis is the lone back in the backfield alongside Garrett. Garrett's in the shotgun. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to his right. Mm-hmm. Got a man behind him, and he just kind of wobbles it out there, and if they intercepted it, there was ridiculous to do that. They would have lost yards, but they didn't. Ball hit the ground, so they'll take over on downs at about the 4-yard line. Yeah, with 4:11 left to go in the third quarter.
You could see that coming. That guy broke off his blocker, and you knew Garrett wasn't going to have time to set up and really put anything on it, and it did fall incomplete. So Aquinas will take over on their own, inside their own 15-yard line. 4:11 to go, 37-0, and we still got number one D out there.
Yes, we do. I imagine we'll see them all of this quarter. We'll probably change over.
Yeah, that's what I'm guessing.
All right, Aquinas takes the snap. They're going to hand to the deep man. Big shock. He's going to run off the right side and find a little bit there, but not a whole lot. Let's see, maybe two, maybe three.
Yeah, a couple yards there, maybe.
All right, with 3:50 left to go in the third quarter, the Red Devils are up 37-0. Here on homecoming, as we've said earlier, Marie Matthews is homecoming queen. Congratulations, Marie. And we have the ball here. Well, you don't have the ball here, sorry. Aquinas has the ball. They got two wideouts left. I formation. The quarterback is under center again. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to his left. Throws quickly across the middle, but overthrows his man. Had it. A little crease there, a little seam if he could have hit him in stride. But it falls incomplete, so it'll be third down and long seven.
Yeah, good pass there, and 88 may still be running. I don't know. He, like you said, he was right in that in a perfect seam, but the QB just couldn't get him the football. So third down and 8, 3:22 to go in the third. We're up 37-0.
All right, Aquinas finally gets the signal in from the sideline. The quarterback's sharing it with the huddle. They break huddle, got a wide out left, wide out right. Two backs in the backfield in an I formation. Quarterback is under center. He's going to take the snap. He's going to fake a handoff. And he's looking out to his right, throws it out there, and he's got a man, catches it in traffic. And he's going to be close to a first down. Let's see where that spot goes. Is that out across the 25? Looks like it is. Yeah, so that's going to be first down Aquinas. With 3:12 left to go in the third quarter, Red Devils up 37-0.
So first down, and they go keep the ball.
All right. Aquinas breaks the huddle. Send a wide out left, wide out right. Got two backs in the backfield. Quarterback's under center. Going to take the snap. He's going to hand to the deep man. He's going to try to run right up the middle. And once again, there's not going to be a whole lot there. But he's going to get some positive yards out of it, and maybe four.
Yep, go give him four whole yards. They just run right off between right tackle and right guard and pick up about 2:40 to go in the third. We're still up 37.
All right. Aquinas gets a signal from the sideline. Quarterback shares it with the huddle. They break huddle, got a wide out left, wide out right, got a tight end on the left end of the line. Got two backs in the backfield in the I formation, quarterback's under center. He's going to take the snap. He hands off to the deep man, and we bump him in the backfield, and then he kind of bounces off of that and might have gotten some positive yards out of that bouncing around a little bit. We should have had him for a loss. Looks like he's going to get yard and a half, maybe two on the play, and it'll be third down and a long four.
Yeah, pretty tough little running by him that time. We hit him two or three times, and he just wouldn't go down. So third, what'd you call it, three and a half, four maybe?
I'd say a bit of four, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Aquinas breaks the huddle. They got a wide out left, wide out right, I formation. Quarterback's under center. He's going to take the snap, and he's going to fake a handoff. We're in the backfield there. They got a man on the side. Number 10 catches it. He bounces off a couple of tacklers and gets out across the 45-yard line out to about the 47-yard line. So it'll be first down Aquinas with a minute 23 left to go in the third quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. But Aquinas is putting together a little drive here.
Yeah, they pick up about 15 yards on that play. And it's going to be a first down and 10 for Aquinas, a minute 23 to go here in the third quarter, and they're trying to put together a little drive here. They started back on their own 15. They've moved it about 31 yards on us now.
All right. Aquinas breaks the huddle. They got a wide out left, wide out right, I formation, quarterback's under center. He's going to take the snap. He's going to hand to the deep man, and again going to run it up the middle, and he's going to get about 3, maybe 4 yards there. Right up the middle out to about the 50-yard line. Just, let's see where they're going to mark it, across the 50 or shy of the 50.
They're going to set it right on top of it.
Right on top of it, yeah. So at midfield now with less than a minute left to go, down to about 40 seconds with the Red Devils up 37-0 here in the third quarter. Aquinas breaks the huddle. They got a wide out left, wide out right, I formation. Quarterback is under center. He's going to take the snap, run to his left, and he's going to keep it and be dropped for a loss. He will not get back to
the line. Ain't no way. That one guy's marking him where he got back to.
I don't know what he was watching, but it wasn't
the play on the field.
He's running
an option, wasn't he? I mean, so he's behind the line.
He was behind the line. He didn't turn anything into the line. He marks it right there on the 50. I have to disagree with him. We'll see if with the film.
This will be the last play of the quarter, and we're up 37 points. And
man, that's going to be such a long walk to switch sides. They'll have to turn the nose of the ball around.
We may have to take a while here, a long time outbreak to, I guess, just pretty much, look, he's just pointing at the ball. Hey, let's just leave it here. All right, so.
Watch him turn the nose of the ball around. Look. He didn't even turn the nose of it around. He just left it there.
Yep, left it there.
All right, well, let's get our sponsors here at the 37-0 headed to the fourth quarter. Red Devils up, and we want to thank our sponsors, Clyatt's Crossing Convenience Store, Doug Newman, State Farm Insurance Agent, Johnson Equipment Repair and Rentals, Lincolnton Auto Sales, Verizon Wireless and Radio Shack of Lincolnton, Turner Realty, Commercial Insurance Services, Lincolnton Marine, R&W Auto Parts, Augusta Telephone Sales and Service, Cox Brothers Builders, Rail EMC, Golf DL, H&H Industries, Spratlin Hardware, American Academy of Manual Medicine, and F&M Bank of Lincolnton, member FDIC. Thank you, folks.
Thank you, Pete, for my chicken wings. Do you like them chicken wings? That was pretty good.
Oh, they were great, I'm telling you. I come up here and the trash can looked like a chicken graveyard.
Well, that was your buddy. Doug done got on them things. But thank you, Pete. Give us some chicken wings, chicken strips, chips. He knows I love them chips soaked in whatever he soaks them in. And he won't tell me what he soaks them in. But I like them.
Oh, see. That way you have to keep coming back and buying them from him.
There you go.
All right, Aquinas at the start of the fourth quarter here. They break the huddle. They got a wide out left, wide out right, I formation. Quarterback's under center. He's going to take the snap. He's looking to his left. Got a man there. Overthrows him a bit, and we lit him up. You know, you come across the middle, you got to have a little bit of a mindset that you're willing to take a pop. And he took a pop and got up there. So it's going to be fourth down, and they're going to punt the ball back to us to begin the fourth quarter, basically. Down inside 12 minutes. In the fourth quarter, Red Devils up 37-0. All right, we'll have Ursell and Devontae back to receive this punt. And their punters had a fair amount of practice tonight. All right, the snap is a good snap. He's going to punt it. It's not going to be a good punt. It's going to be kind of low, and Ursel's going to kind of watch it and get out of the way. It's going to roll inside the 10. It's going to end up good that way. Down around the 9, just inside the 9 perhaps. We'll take over with 11:06 left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. Let's see about this offense. I can't imagine we're going to see backups right here. Yeah, I can't imagine in this position we'd see backups. Not right here. We ain't going to drop the ball right here.
Yeah. So, 10, and we are on a clock run now. Continual clock run. 10:40 to go in the game, and everything will just run from here out.
All right, we got 3 wideouts left, 1 wideout right. Steven Morse is in the backfield alongside Garrett. Garrett's going to take the snap in the shotgun, and he's just going to pull it down and run a quarterback draw up the middle, and he's going to get some yardage out there, out across the 20-yard line, out to about the 23. So it'll be first down
15
and
yards.
Goal to go. Yeah. Just kidding.
15 yards that time by Garrett. Just that was a design play. Just take the snap and find you a hole and go, and he runs for about 15-yard pickup. First and 10, Lincoln County. The clock is running, and we're up 37-0.
That's all it. Right, 2 wideouts left, 2 wideouts right, 1 back in the backfield alongside Garrett in the shotgun. He takes a snap, looks out to his right, throws out there. Got a man. That's Tyler. No, Sagas. That's Mason Sagas over there. And Mason's going to get out up almost to the 45-yard line. About there. Looks like they're going to spot him at the 43.
Yeah, so that's a 20-yard pickup. Out to Mason.
Mason just ran out there and kind of sat down in that open spot in the zone. And
yeah,
Garrett fired it out there. Did a good job turning the ball and turning around and going upfield.
Yep. Mason shows a little bit of speed out there. Young Sag.
And like Addison said, the clock is on a continuous run now. We're up 37-0 in the fourth quarter with around 9 minutes left to go. We break the huddle. Got 2 wideouts left, 2 wideouts right, 1 back in the backfield. Garrett's in the shotgun. Takes the snap. He's looking, got some pressure, and he's going to be dropped for a loss back. Oh, let's see. Back to about the 38-yard line. Unfortunate. No, 39-yard line is where they're going to spot him. So that'll be second down and about 15 after that sack inside of 9 minutes. 8:50 to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. We've got a few second stringers in there, but not a lot. But you get, like Addison said, we play a lot of young players all the way around anyway, so it's not like you got a long ways to go. Pardon that slight interruption.
We come
takes
the
snap, and he's going to get positive yards out there to Craig. Craig's going to get right out to the 50-yard line with 8:20 left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. We'll have about a third down and a long, well, I'd say long 3, but it's really 4, so I'll call it 4.
So we've got the clock running, and this game shouldn't last but about 8 more minutes.
There you go.
You know, so 37.
Can't stop unless somebody calls a timeout.
Right.
All right, we break the huddle. Got 3 wideouts to the right, 1 wideout to the left, 1 back in the backfield. Garrett's in the shotgun. He's going to take the snap. He's looking, steps up, throws over to the left. Got hit about the time he went to throw, and that just made it look like a wounded duck coming out of there. And not the best pass, but he was under duress there. So it's going to be 4th and 4 to go from the 49-and-a-half-yard line. We need to get to the 46 in Aquinas territory to get a first down.
Yep, and with the clock running, we're going to just go ahead and go for it. Might as well.
Or, you know, with Garrett out there, we could do a little punt. I mean, you don't have to change.
Right, that's true.
We could get in that formation and drop back a little bit and punt it. All right, it looks like a shotgun formation. 2 wideouts left, 2 wideouts right. He's looking downfield, going to throw. Got Bon Turner there, and Addison hit him in the hands. Unfortunately, yep. Bon was ready to run with it.
Yep, before he caught it.
Didn't come up with it, but, you know, those things happen. So Aquinas is going to take over the ball at the 49-and-a-half-yard line, already in our territory with about 6:40 left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. All right, well, you get to enjoy Aquinas' drum corps. Enjoy being a very loosely used term. All right, we have some backups in here now on defense. Yes, sir, we do. We got Caleb Jones out there, and we've got Tyler Woodall out there, who both backups. Aquinas in the I formation, looking to his right, throws out there, just didn't make too good a pass that time, to be honest.
Can't make a connection at all right now, it seems like, for him.
That doesn't stop the clock either, remember?
Nope, right.
It's a continuous clock, so it is inside 6 minutes now, 37-0 Red Devils. And we do have a bunch of, let's see, who else we got out there? We got Deshaun Taylor, who I know is a freshman. Man, we got all sorts of folks out there. Devin Harrison, let's see. All right, Aquinas, I formation, wide out left, wide out right. Going to give to the deep man. He's going to go right through the middle, and he's got some room there.
Fumble.
And he fumbles the ball, and that is Caleb Jones, who fell on the ball, and I think we're going to take back over there at the 37-yard line, looks like. Big Caleb James got in there and recovered that fumble.
They lay it down, and we get it after they done picked up about 13, 12 yards on that carry.
I think I called him Jones because Doug's sheet here has it Jones, but I know it's James. Yeah, it's got, but it's Caleb James. That's James James's son, James and Karen's son. So
we'll take back over with a continual clock running at 5 minutes.
All righty. We take the ball in the shotgun formation. He's got a little time, steps up there and hits Sagas. Bounces off him. It's going to be intercepted by number 40 for them, and he's going to be brought down by Dalton. Dropped out at about the 36-yard line. So that was very
okay. We don't want it. You take it. So they pick us off right after we covered a fumble, and they'll take over first and 10. We do have a flag, they say.
See what this flag is.
Did we hit him late? Or?
Well, we certainly haven't had enough penalties against us tonight.
Dead ball.
Personal foul.
All nice. Us.
Yep. So they're going to give him extra 15 yards.
Really?
I sure would like to see our backup defense here keep them blanked.
Yep, that'd be nice.
And the clock does stop with that, by the way. So it's 4:35 left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. And
they don't have, 21?
Yeah, they are on our 21 now. They'll take over first and 10 with 4:35 left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. Aquinas is in the I formation, wide out left, wide out right. Quarterback's under center. He takes a snap. He's looking to his right. Throws it out there, and is going to be intercepted by Tyler Woodall, and he is going to break it out, running out the 20, 25, 30. He gets tackled there by the quarterback. He didn't like going an interception. And so Tyler Woodall gets an interception there and gets it back out to, they're going to spot it at the 30. Yep, about the 30.
All right, sweet. That's our third interception of the night for Lincoln County.
All right. Quarterback is going to be in the shotgun again. Got two wideouts left, two wideouts right, one back in the backfield. We got some more subs in here on offense. Quarterback's going to take the snap. He's got a man quickly coming off the side. Throws the ball out to Caleb a little high and a little hard to come up with that.
Yeah, pressure came mighty quick, and he really didn't have time even for Caleb to hardly get his head around. And
that's a tough part of the four wideouts.
Sometimes somebody
just comes clean, and it's really got to get rid of the ball quick at times. Well, as we said before, we're on a continuous clock, so that doesn't stop the clock. It is 3 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. We're at second and 10. Garrett's in the shotgun. We got three wideouts left, one wideout right, one back in the backfield. Garrett's going to take the snap, steps up, and he's going to run a draw. Maybe get about 4 yards. That was kind of a late hit there, ref.
It's getting close, wasn't it?
Yeah, and plus he was leading with the helmet. That's what I don't like to see. That's late in the game. I don't want to see any of our boys get hurt. So we're going to call it 3-yard gain. It'll be 3rd and 7 with 2.5 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. Von Turner comes in from the sideline with the play, gives it to Garrett. Garrett runs over to the guys and tells them what the play is. We break the huddle. And we got three wideouts left, one wideout right, back in the backfield alongside Garrett. Garrett low snap, and he's going to run a draw again, and we're just content to try to run some clock here. And he gets out across the 35, maybe to about the 36. So we're going to call it, I'll call that a gain of two, and it'll be fourth and five.
And it looks like, is this our first punt of the night?
Yes, it is.
Wow. I wonder if there's ever been a game we've not ever punted.
This season?
No, ever.
Oh, I'm sure there has. Sure.
Yeah, I would think
all
so.
The years Lincoln County's had good teams? Yeah, I would think so. There's somewhere along
there. Well, this, we just about made it.
Yeah, with less than 2 minutes to go, we're finally having a punt. Garrett's in this punt formation. It's a good snap. He takes the punt, and he kicks a low, just shot.
Whoa.
That ball's going to land at the 20, get inside down to about the 15, and I believe they
One, he's acting like he touched it, but they're going
to. I don't think they're going to give it to us. They're not going to give it to us, even though I believe he did touch it.
Yeah.
Oh, ref, he reached out and put a hand on it. He sure did, but I don't know. We're down around a minute.
In the meantime, the clock is running. Boy, that was a booming punt, though. I mean, that thing went forever, didn't it?
Yeah, we had the ball, at the 37?
If they don't know definitely that he touched it, there's no way they can give us the football.
Right.
That's just a fact, Jack.
All right, with a minute 15 left to go in the fourth quarter, Red Devils up 37-0. And this is, as Dandy Don used to say on Monday Night Football, you can start the bus, turn out the lights,
that's
the party's over. All right, again, a number of subs in there on defense. And we got a wide out left, wide out right, eye formation. Quarterback takes a snap, gives to the tailback. He's going to run off the right side, and he's going to be dropped by Caleb James there. Going to get a couple of positive yards. But it is clicking down quickly here with 45 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. Red Devils up 37-0. Might see one more offensive play here before this game is over.
Yeah, they'll get one more off.
All right, Aquinas wide out left, wide out right. Eye formation, quarterback under center, takes a snap, gives to the deep man. He tries to go up the middle, and Caleb meets him along with others in there. Number 59, that would be Dekemus Zellers. And that is going to be the ball game, folks. There's under 15, under 12.
Yeah, we'll see, Dan, if you can get a hold of Coach.
Or Dave.
Dave, did I say Dan? Dave, whoever, you know what I'm talking about down there. Buddy, my buddy.
All right, y'all got me? Y'all got me? All right. I don't think anybody's seen that coming today. The boys come out and played hard today.
Well, we played the first half as good as we played all year. And, you know, we made a lot of substitutions. I wasn't real pleased with the second half. First half has looked as good as we've looked all year.
Thank you, Coach.
That's it.
All right.
All right, folks, we are back here. The game is over now. Red Devils win it 37-0 on homecoming night over the Aquinas Irish.
Friday night showdown, when the devil's in the field, you'll hear a roar through the whole town. The field's all ready, so somebody get the lights. It's Lincoln County football here on Football Friday night. So come on, all you fans of the mighty red and white, and
see the red devils get another win tonight.